Hey guys, Wade Grata here, playing a little Sector Control on Sarajevo Stadium, and of course, I'm very familiar with this particular map, because this was in the beta, and I played beta on the Xbox, although I do play PlayStation 3 now, but I do have an Xbox as well, and it was a lot of fun. This is the only map available, so I'm pretty versed in it since I played the pants off of it. Using, of course, the pink camo, tactical pink. F88 AUG. I'm still trying to get all the unlocks because the optics on this gun are absolutely atrocious, and I really think I'm only a couple kills away from getting the last unlock. I need to get like some mastery tag or something like that, but I think I just got like 500 kills with it, so I think I have one more unlock left, and I'm hoping it's a better reticle than the previous ones that I have unlocked, since they're all pretty awful. Honestly, they're all pretty awful. So if it's not any better than the ones that I already have, then I'm probably just not going to be using this gun anymore. The gun seems powerful. It is one of the first unlockable guns that you do get for the Point Man class, which is what I'm playing with here. But the sights are just absolutely garbage. The other guns have so much better apertures. The apertures with this particular gun really do handicap it. And what I'm kind of waiting for is just like a normal red dot, or maybe like a Russian red dot Cobra style sight that I can just kind of like point and shoot with, like kind of up close and personal. But all these sights on this gun are just for like made for like distances, like trying to pick people off, which there's a time and a place for that. But with my style of gameplay, it really precipitates me needing be able to use a gun like up close, and there's quite a few deaths that I do take on throughout my gameplay, as I get a mutual kill right there, that I need us to be able to whip the thing around and still be able to focus on the enemy in front of me, where I can't do that with this particular sight. And this is actually the least magnification sight, the one I'm using right now, and I still don't like it. Try to be able to use it a little more effectively than I have in the past. So, you know, I try to adapt to this particular aperture and make do, so you know, to the best of my abilities. But you know, I do post better scores with other rifles inside of the Point Man class, and of course, having the shotgun as a secondary helps out a lot. Now, I am playing by myself this round, and I only take on 2 deaths the entire game, but you'll see here, the guy I was playing with in this session, he kept ending up on my fire team, was really bad. I don't know if he just was like new to the game, or he's just actually that bad at the game, or he's bad at games in general, or just this particular game, I'm not really sure, but you'll see where he's standing when I have to spawn in on him, and it's ridiculous. I could have spawned back and been in just as good a position. I was in no fear at all of being in any good position when I spawned in this guy. But doing some work, you know, I absolutely love the Point Man class. It's my favorite class, and what I'm trying to do here, really, and I have been playing with it a lot lately, is trying to, of course, get all the sights unlocked for the F-88 AUG AUG. But I'm also trying to get the Point Man class up to tier 1 level, and once I unlock all the stuff for the AUG, I'll switch back over to a stronger rifle for the Point Man class, and I'm sure I'll get it without a doubt. I think I only have maybe like 50 some kills at the time I'm sitting here right now until I get tier 1 for the Point Man class, and I'll probably work on the Assaulter class because I'm pretty close to that as well, and then go from there. And of course, my goal, the end result of all this, is I want to get tier 1 with every class, sniper included, demolition included. And, you know, I do see a lot of people playing like demolition team deathmatch. I know my girl Miss Artemis, you know, she plays demolition team deathmatch. It's like, it's moved entirely too slow for me.
Double kill.
So in a team deathmatch, you're definitely always going to see me use a lot faster classes. Of course, Point Man class being one of the fastest classes, Spec Ops class being a faster class. But look where this guy is. I'm getting ready to spawn on my buddy. He is all the way in the back of the map, protecting a flag that we were in no fear of losing by any means with the sniper on. It's just like, what are you doing? like you are being totally worthless right now, except for the fact that I can spawn on you. We're in an absolute worthless position. And you'll see here at the end of the, he does not post a very good score at the end of the round as well. So, and that was kind of what I was subjected to as he tries to troll me there, because I think I was cussing him out on a microphone, like, you know, dude, you need to move up, be useful, you know, switch classes or something, man. But you know, I think he got a little mad at me, so he was trying to troll me, maybe for an ammo pack because I didn't resupply him on purpose initially, just because I was kind of pissed off that I had to spawn in way back there. And of course, you know, part of that whole thing is just like, you know, he could have helped me out a little bit, maybe if he was up, you know, a little more up close to the battle and everything. And I know if I was playing with one of my buddies, like I know if I was playing with Artemis, I know if I was playing with Laguna or Dawn of Death, or I Know You Not, or any of those guys that I play a lot of Medal of Honor with, that wouldn't have happened. So it's a little frustrating.
Killing spree.
But even so, you know, I still had a good round, still was able to post a decent score. And Sector Control can be very enjoyable at times, although sometimes I find when I do have, I'm playing with a lot of friends and we're just totally overpowering the other team, it can actually be a little frustrating. It's just, you know, I don't think Sector Control is that fun when you're just able to spawn camp the other team over and over and over again. But you see here, I mean, they had at least one flag the entire time. We tried to cap the south flag, but they ended up getting it back pretty much right away. So at least it was a little more competitive in that aspect, although they were not a very good team. But took home top fire team, even though my buddy was 1-5 with 400 some odd points. But of course, definitely take home the win there and had a lot of fun. That's the most important thing. Thank you.